I'm very excited to share with you some breaking news about pancreatic cancer research, which will certainly reveal a great potential for development of new therapies for pancreatic cancer. Hello and welcome to another episode of Cancer Education and Research Institute. Today, I'm very excited to share with you some breaking news about pancreatic cancer research, which study was published on May 2nd, 2019. This study was performed by researchers from New York University and New York University Langone Health PerlmutterCancer Center, as well as University of Michigan. And these researchers have found the gene that is necessary for the development of pancreatic cancer. Isn't that amazing? This is so exciting. This is phenomenal. These researchers have first thought that by inhibiting or blocking this gene, that the cancer progression will be slowing down. However, to their surprise, when they inhibited, diminished this gene, the researchers have found that pancreatic cancer didn't even exist. It actually didn't develop. So this is fantastic news, and I'm so very excited to share with you. We have also written right away about this on our website. So now let's talk about pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma, PDA. Actually, the researchers have worked on this pancreatic cancer type, which is the most aggressive form of pancreatic cancer, which is driven by the oncogenic KRAS. As well as this PDA or pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma is usually detected in a late stage of the cancer, as well as it is resistant to therapy. So these researchers worked on this pancreatic cancer type, the PDA, pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma, and they found that Atdc gene is responsible for the pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma PDA to develop. The Atdc gene is overexpressed, which we call overexpressed or in high copy numbers, in pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma in PDA. And the researchers have shown that when they blocked or inhibited this gene in context of oncogenic KRAS, the pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma didn't develop. However, when ATDC gene was present, then in context of oncogenic KRAS, in the mice experiments they have conducted, these experiments, all mice have developed PDA or pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma. So this study showed a direct correlation between ATDC gene and pancreatic cancer development. How fantastic is that? Congratulations. I'm going to read you a quote from the senior author of the study, which is Dr. Diane Simeone, who is also the director of the Pancreatic Cancer Center of the New York University Langone Health PerlmutterCancer Center. And she says, "We thought the deletion of the gene would slow down the growth, not completely preventing it." That's unbelievable. So if you're interested in how the mechanism works in context of the ATDC gene and pancreatic cancer development, the researchers have found that the ATDC gene promotes acina ductal metaplasia, ADM, into pancreatic intraepithelial neoplasia, PANIN, through beta-catenin, which consequently upregulates or increases the numbers of SOX9. And this is how the mechanism works. In other words, ATDC promotes the tumor development, which goes from acina ductal metaplasia into the pancreatic intraepithelial neoplasia. This is again very, very exciting news. I'm so happy to share this information with you, especially for our pancreatic cancer patients to whom for years I have been saying that unfortunately there's not much research going on, or unfortunately there's not a real treatment for pancreatic cancer at this time, or we don't know much about the new treatment options, on the research is not there yet. And this is why I am particularly so super excited about this research for pancreatic cancer patients. So this is really great news, and this research most certainly revealed the great hope for development of new potential therapies for pancreatic cancer. This study was published, as I said, on May 2nd, 2019, and is published in a journal which is called Genes and Development. And the link for this article, for the origin article, you can find it on our website. And the, as I said, the corresponding author of this study is Dr. Diane Simeone. And the email address for this author is also found on our website. So I hope this was helpful, and if you like this video, and I'm sure you are as much as excited as I am right now, please give us a like this video, share this video, help many people learn about this exciting cancer research development, the breaking news in pancreatic cancer. And also I would like you to please hit the subscribe button down here and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't miss our next upcoming videos. And if you don't want to miss them, when once you subscribe, you will see a bell, and please click on the bell so that you can get notification when we next time publish our videos. So thank you so much again, and I will see you in the next video. And before I go, please watch these videos around me, and we have a plenty of other videos. Especially I would recommend you to watch the carcinoma, what is carcinoma video, which is one of our most popular videos. Okay, thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. So we hope this was helpful to you. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more cancer videos. And once you subscribe, don't forget to hit the bell so that you can be informed when we publish our new video. Thanks again for watching, and we will see you in the next episode.